I've had the opportunity of traveling with him, being with him in many situations at many places. If I say that we are in the company of Raghu Rai, who is an icon, who is a legend, who has seen so much in the last, say, more than 40 years. He started photography sometime in 1966. So almost a major part of the independent India, he has traversed the width and length of this country, seen many ups and downs. He has covered the most difficult situations. He has been witnessing and capturing history the way no other Indian photographer, probably any other photographer in the world, has done so as he has. We are so fortunate to in his company that he has, with his tender, caring, loving heart, captured those moments in a way that we can really feel that feeling of love, tenderness, and concern in those pictures, which is really visible to all of us. This man, I repeat what I said earlier, people for centuries to come will remember that he lived in this country, that he came to the city of Chandigarh, that he, we know that he has seen very difficult situation, be it, you know, Blue Star operation, be it, you know, Bhopal tragedy. This country has been fortunate and unfortunate in many different ways. There are moments which are, you know, heartwarming, the moments which we really, you know, would better forget. But he, with his stamina, with his strength, with his sense of freedom and liberty, he has been able to face all the situations. He faced the mighty Indira Gandhi. He faced the humble people of, you know, flood-stricken areas. I don't really know how to express those feelings. I'll give you one simple example. One day, I was sitting with him in his Khan Market house, Ravindranagar house. He was, you know, giving some water and tendering the small plants. And then we went inside, he was designing a catalog for me. He doesn't need to design a catalog for Diwan. I was even younger at that time. But he very humbly, he said, I'll do that. And at the same time, he was having his retrospective at the National Modern Art Gallery, and he was preparing for that show. His little daughter, who's now 13, at that time she was hardly, I think, one and a half year old, he had his full tray of negatives. We can imagine what negatives could be there of Bresson, of Indira Gandhi, you know, of the history of India. She walks into the tray and he did not react. He said, oh, bitte, kya kar rahe ho? By the time he came to that, she started chewing the negative. Had it been somebody else, probably would have gotten angry with his wife or with the ayah or with the child itself. He did not lose his temper at all. He said, "Alle bichu kya kar le ho, dena dena." He very tenderly, quietly, gently took the negatives away. That could be of Bresson, of Indira Gandhi, of any important historical moment. That is the way I express his love, his care, his concern. His another love is nature, environment, plants. His beautiful wife, very qualified, beautiful wife, very intelligent, beautiful wife, she has built a castle kind of a house, a farmhouse near Delhi with chuna and, you know, original Nanakshahi eat. There he took me to the attic. We were standing there. He said, Devan, look around. Is desh mein har, is ghar mein is har kone ki desh ki mitti. मैंने कहा कैसे? जहां भी मैं जाता हूं वहां का एक प्लांट ले आता हूं. हर जगह इन्होंने, यहां से नहीं, मैंने खुद देखा है, जहाज में अपनी गोदी में प्लांट को रख के, इन वेरी डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन, वी फ्लाइंग फ्रॉम नागालैंड और बनारस और सम अदर प्लेस वेर देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ पैकिंग इट नाइसली एंड ही हैज टू टेक इट. इट मे वे 50 किलोज और लेस ऑफ मोर, बट ही हैज टू डू इट. This is the way I describe Raghu Rai. I would not be in between you and him for long, but I'd like to once again thank you all for really for this encouraging response to our academy. And the academy is trying to do things in its own humble way. If we falter somewhere, I would request you to forgive me, but expect to change. If you suggest something, I'd like to bring about the change you suggest if suits us. I would not say I'll change everything you say, but I'm sure most of you are well-meaning people, have wonderful ideas. You'll keep us giving the support you have given us till now. Thank you so much.
क्या बात है दीवान साहब की जो उन्होंने इतना बारूद भर दिया मेरे में. अगर गालिब होते तो इस आतिश का क्या इस्तेमाल करते मैं जान नहीं सकता. ये जो अदा है ना, ये एक्सप्रेशन जो है, इससे बहुत लाभ है. यू गैदर योर एनर्जीज टुगेदर एंड व्हेन यू बाउ योर हेड you can always feel, you know, that he is blessing you. And you know, these little gestures of ours in India have very special significance for all of us. You see, I'd like to share a few experiences, the way from an ordinary civil engineer to a photographer, how my life has changed. You see, accidents happen in anybody's life. I never thought of becoming a photographer, but my elder brother, Mr. S. Paul, who's still a very passionate man about photography, I came to stay with him. And I discovered, you know, everyone who came to meet him was a photographer. You know, they will get a new lens or a new camera and there'll be so much of excitement in the room. They'll take a picture, you know, somebody has taken an interesting different picture of different situation. They get together and make such a difference and excitement that, look, you know, what a moment you've captured. And I used to think, you know, what a mad lot, you know. That they've got nothing better to do, you know. They have, my brother didn't have enough clothes, you know, but he had so many cameras and lenses. His suitcases were full of films and, you know, photographic paper. And he was not bothered about it, you know. And I used to say, you know, oh my God, you know, this is very strange. Till one day, one of his close friends, why I have to mention this is because Mr. Yogjoy, who was the chief photographer of Tribune, and a very wonderful, loving man. He used to come and share his works with my brother. So one day he said he was going to his village to take some pictures. And since I was doing nothing, I decided to go with him. And while leaving, I asked my brother, I said, why don't you give me a camera? I'll also go and take a few pictures. Can we see that first picture, please? So just by the way, I also carried a normal camera with a normal lens. And we went to his village. Yogjoy was very gentle and very sensitive man, but he was a bit also very shy. So he was taking some pictures of the children outside the village very carefully. And I was standing by, I didn't know what to do. So suddenly I turned around, only the first picture, huh? I turned around and I saw this baby donkey looking very gentle, sweet and buddhu. So, you know, I said, okay, let me take this picture. And since I had an ordinary camera and with an ordinary lens, so I had to get very close to the animal. And as I started getting closer, he got scared, he started running. And I followed a bit and the children started laughing. So I started running behind this baby donkey and children were having a great time and I was very happy that the children were very happy. So, you know, I kept chasing the baby donkey. It was late evening till this animal got tired and stood there right in front of me. And I took this picture. And I came back, my brother saw this picture, he says, wonderful. You know, at that time, the Times newspaper, London, used to carry half-page picture of something humorous, something ironic, something funny, something strange. So they published this picture and with my name So I thought, wow, that makes some sense, you know. And the money they sent me for one picture was enough for me to carry on for 2 months. So I said, you know, why don't I try doing this, you know? But the important part is when then my brother gave me a better camera, and then I started photographing daily life and anything, you know, that came my way. But the precious thing about camera was that each time I put it on my eye and looked at the world through the camera, my concentration, my energies were getting absolutely concentrated, and I could take a closer look at the world. And I started relating and discovering and exploring, you know. It was not just that, you know, I also want to become a photographer, you know. So it was the other way around, you know, that really through the lens, you know, it became a kind of a yogic exercise for me, that I could really take a very close look at the world. And this is how the passion grew and things started happening in front of me. You know, I tell youngsters, you know, that, you know, in any given situation, you know, there is so much happening all the time. Only thing is, you know, we don't have the patience to explore. The problem with bulk of us, where I'll also say I've spent millions of years doing repetitive work, and why I would like to share, you know, my feelings with everybody, and especially the youngsters who want to get into photography, is that we have wasted millions of years directionlessly. At least now, you know, we can share something which is very precise and to the point. And really, because what happens is, you know, when you start taking pictures, we are all basically programmed human machines. The computers started very recently, but the computer installed here by the nature, by the God himself, is the biggest ever computer, and it keeps all memories, sounds and sights stored here. And especially in terms of photography, you know, you've seen so many good pictures all over, and all those good pictures are stored here. So when we pick up a camera and we walk into the streets and we see something similar, and we go bang, you know, take a picture. So, you know, you go on clicking pictures, and at the end of the day when you come home, and if you look at your work very critically, you discover ki haan, aisa bhi dekha hai, waisa bhi dekha hai. Dekhiye, bulk of the, you see, first of all, art is not about beauty, not at all. Art is about human expression and capturing human energy and human interaction. That's the magic where, you know, the current, the image will stay alive. It's not about making a situation look beautiful or capture a beautiful landscape or a beautiful face. Beauty comes much later. First, it's the expression, the intensity, and the magic of daily life, or any important event, or any big personality that you're photographing, that you make a connection, you capture the energy, the character of the person, and then, you know, you share it with the world, it makes more sense. But what is happening is, most of us, most of the time, we are controlled by this mind. And that mind is so programmed from childhood to schooling to colleges to you know, friends and relationships, that we are getting tuned and programmed on one level. And that one level of nicety and mediocrity, and, well, you know, what I photograph, you know, you see it and it is familiar to you. And you say, yes, it's a nice picture, but for God's sake, you know, this kind of images have been done to death, you know. You see, I was telling the photographer's workshop this morning and yesterday also, that bachcho, I have come here not to give you any kind of capsule that you will start taking good pictures. I have come to ukhado you from wherever you've settled down. Kyunki human mind ki ye tendency hai, ki hum aram अच्छापन कि यार देखो अच्छा तो है, मेहनत तो की है, तो सेटल होने लगते हैं. जिंदगी जो है बोरिंग रेपिटेटिव लगने लगती है क्योंकि हमने सेंस ऑफ एक्सप्लोरेशन जो है उसको खो दिया है. वो जो सेंस ऑफ एक्सप्लोरेशन है टू डिस्कवर समथिंग न्यू, टू इंटरेक्ट विद न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड न्यू एनर्जीज, टू मेक अ डिफरेंस टू आवर ओन लाइव्स टू बिगिन विद, यू नो, एंड विद द रिजल्ट everybody is doing nice pretty pictures, and somebody who's designed this word, you know, infotainment, you know, they have brought down level of sensitivity to entertainment, you know. Look at the most of the newspapers and magazines in the country, you know, it's you know, 8 pages 12 pages of cinema, Bollywood kachra, and mostly it's full with the same politicians and politics and those kind of faces. You see, the newspapers and magazines are in big cities to serve the big guys. Jo ordinary daily life insano ki, jo rozmarra ki zindagi hai, usse taluk, uske saath rishtedari, nate, sab dur hai, kya zarurat hai. Once in a while they have social cause. Today newspapers and magazines, they survey the market and they readjust their, you know, editorial policy in order to sell more. वो भी जमाना था जब हम न्यूज़पेपर या मैगजीन के लिए, व्हाट इज द मेन कॉज ऑफ एनी, वेदर इट्स पॉलिटिकल ट्रबल और वेदर इट्स काइंड ऑफ अ सोशल प्रॉब्लम एंड व्हाट इज रियली वरिंग द कंट्री, वी वुड बिगिन फ्रॉम देयर, स्टार्ट सर्चिंग एंड एक्सप्लोरिंग व्हाट एल्स कैन बी डन इन दिस कंट्री, वेयर वी bring these ideas closer to people and to important people who matter, and maybe they will make a difference. But now everything has become so easy. It's infotainment time and everybody has to be entertained. Similarly, photography also must look pretty and nice. And people who go to buy works of art, I have seen, you know, in big exhibitions, or even if known painters or known photographers, you know, they are looking for images and colors, you know, which match their drawing room's upholstery. And the reporters, you know, in the morning, a lady has come from some newspaper to report about the garbage in my neighborhood. In the evening, she turns up at my exhibition to write about art. So this is the level of sensitivity in this country. You know, you meet any intelligent person in Bollywood, any actor, and when you start talking to them and you discover they are fairly intelligent, sensitive people, and then you ask them ki aap to badi samajh aur badi sensitivity se baat kar rahe hain, par aap wo film kaise banate hain, wo kehte hain this is what the public wants. This is such a disgrace that we come down to that level of entertainment. ये भारत देश है जहां हमारे सुपरस्टार मिरिंडा और पेप्सी बेचते हैं और हम सारे उनको देख के इतना खुश होते हैं. और ये भारत देश है कि अब तो सारी दुनिया के क्रिकेटर्स भी, क्रिकेट भी हमने खरीद लिया है, और यहाँ हमारे जो इतने बड़े बड़े क्रिकेटर्स जो अच्छे इंसान भी हैं, जैसे सचिन तेंदुलकर, वो रात के 3 बजे तक फिल्में शूट करते हैं और सुबह हिंदुस्तान के लिए मैच खेलने जाते हैं. वो हिंदुस्तान जिसमें सिर्फ क्रिकेट ही एक ऐसी स्पोर्ट्स है जिसमें पूरा देश इंतज़ार कर रहा होता है. You see, these are the questions to be asked on every level. कि हमें क्या होता जा रहा है. तो ठीक उसी तरह आज फोटोग्राफी में इतनी डाइल्यूशन है. इन जर्नलिज्म इट हैज बिकम रियली सो डिफरेंट एंड सो अनबिलीवेबल. एंड देर आर 36 पेजेस, 48 पेजेस, बिकॉज मोर मनी इज टू बी मेड, मोर एड्स हैव टू बी पुट. And this transition for me, you know, I remember, you know, when we were young, you know, our elders used to say, अरे हमारे जमाने में ऐसा होता था. मुझे ये कहते हुए बुरा लगता है कि हमारे जमाने में कैसा होता था. मेरा जमाना, देखिए मैं एज की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ, ये भी मेरा जमाना है. बिकॉज आई डोंट बिलीव इन नॉस्टैल्जिक नॉनसेंस, क्योंकि मैं आज भी जीता और जागता हूँ, और मेरे लिए आज अभी भी जो है मेरा देश उतना ही इम्पोर्टेंट है कि यहाँ पे हर लेवल पे हम क्या करते हैं. तो ये भी मेरा ज़माना है, और क्योंकि मैं इंटरेक्ट करता हूं लाइफ से, तो मैं इस जिम्मेवारी से वाकिफ हूं कि हमें ये खेल जो है कब तक हम एक्सेप्ट करते जाएंगे एंड वी गो ऑन डूइंग इट. बट कमिंग बैक टू फोटोग्राफी, यू नो आई हैव in all these years I started from ordinary daily street pictures to photographing, you know, then I joined journalism. I photographed Indira Gandhi very extensively for many years, and that's why I have been able to do many books on Indira Gandhi. Can we see some of the pictures of Indira Gandhi? Dekhiye how nice it makes you laugh. This is not Indira Gandhi, I promise you. ये तो चौरसिया साहब है, नहीं ये नहीं, म्यूजिशियंस का नहीं. चलो मदर टेरेसा दिखाइए, मदर टेरेसा दिखाइए. देखिए मदर टेरेसा एक ऐसी मदर थी, इंदिरा आ गई, इंदिरा जी आ गई. देखिए देखिए उनके हाथों की सुंदरता देखिए, एंड हर एक्सप्रेशन एंड द वे शी सेड्स, शी वाज अमेजिंग लेडी. देयर वर टाइम्स व्हेन शी कुड लुक सो एलिगेंट एंड सो चार्मिंग एंड सो केयरिंग. And then, next moment, in any given political situation, you will see her, her eyes calculating, manipulating who is what and where. This is our former president, V.V. Giri. अब उनको कितना gently, वो देखिए कितनी gentle है और कितने gentle तरीके से कुछ कहा है कि ये कर डालो, तो उनकी हवा सरक गई. नेक्स्ट चलिएगा, थैंक यू. नेक्स्ट चलिएगा, ये देखिए, ये इंदिरा जी का खास एक्सप्रेशन था. जब वो किसी भी गिवन सिचुएशन में बैठती थी तो वो देखती थी और कैलकुलेट करती थी, एंड यू कैन सी दैट. एंड यू सी इन टर्म्स ऑफ फॉर्म्स एंड कंपोजिशन, ऑल दोज लाइंस कन्वर्जिंग, यू नो, इमर्जिंग एट वन प्लेस फ्रॉम एंड देन गोइंग आउट, यू नो, और कमिंग इन डाउनवर्ड, यू नो, and to closer to her expression, they energize her journey and expression. You know, this is how we look at pictures, you know. Next, ye dekhiye, they said she was the only man in her cabinet, you know, so you can see everybody else, all those congressmen, many senior ones, the way they are waiting for the orders, and the man on the extreme right is nobody else but R.K. Dhawan. You can watch his expressions. You see, photography started about 160 years ago, and you know the purpose of photography for me is very specific, and which is that it started 160 years ago, and the British brought two photographers, Bond and Shepherd, to Calcutta, and they started photographing British Empire and their lifestyle, and Indians and their lifestyle, very systematically. So imagine a picture taken of a Chaurangi Square 160 years ago by that group, those two photographers, Bond and Shepherd. And when you look at the painting done by maybe Hussain or Gujral of that time, and when you look at the painting done 160 years ago, you say, yes, very nice painting. But when you look at the photograph, the first response is, oh my God, that's the way it used to be. Now, you are being, when you look at that picture taken 150, 60 years ago, when cameras were slow, lenses were slow, films were slow, you had to carry a camera on a tripod and make everybody sit static, and people have done the images which are relevant and powerful. And today the technology has changed so much. So when you look at that picture, you say, oh my God, that's the way we used to be. Means you are being carried physically into that situation the way it existed 160 years ago. So to my journalist friends and writers, I tell them, you know, history can be written and rewritten, but photo history cannot be rewritten. And this is the photo history of our time. And we have to be equally sensitive and responsible in terms of receiving and perceiving and then capturing the truth of the moment in totality, so that what we captured today, maybe after 100 years, people will get to see, you know, and understand. You know, today Archaeological Survey of India is buying pictures from British Library, because British Library has got treasures from all over the world, you know, the great, best photographs taken of all monuments and places, you know. So if you want to restore your monuments also, you go back to the images, those were done in those years. So this is a very specific purpose which cannot be replaced by any other medium, you know. Let's see the next one. Indra. Next, Shalika. You see, Indraji said she loves the Himalayas. This was during Simla summit. So I sent in a request. I said, since you say that, you know, won't it be a good idea if you let me take pictures? And she was kind enough. But, you know, the lawns on which we were walking, this wall was coming in the way. So I said, Indraji, can you go up, you know, and walk on this wall? She said, sure. But just look at her body language, her gesture, her mudra dekhiye, unke haath ki, dekha hai. She was so careful about everything when she was would be being photographed by somebody special in special moments. She'll take care of her pallu, her sari, her gesture, her body language. She was very alert. I remember once she said, you know, you come home, you know, you take picture with my grandchildren. So as I walk in, it was towards the evening, she was tired by that time. And I walk in, and what do I see through the corridor? She's tired and hanging on to the door like this. And the moment I tried to pick up my camera, immediately she stood like this. Chaliye, next dekhiye. ये तो आप पहचानते हैं ना, ये जेस्चर जो है कांग्रेस में और सारे पॉलिटिशियन, सभी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ने इनहेरिट किया है. एंड दे आर नो बेटर, आई प्रॉमिस यू. चलिए नेक्स्ट. चलिए, दिस इज भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी, एन अननोन चाइल्ड बीइंग बैरिड, यू नो, विच बिकेम ऑलमोस्ट अ सिंबल ऑफ भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी. एंड देन यू नो द मेनी एनजीओज एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस कलेक्टेड लॉट ऑफ मनी on the basis of this photograph, and the rest of the picture I sent them for the purpose, you know. Chaliye, next. Is pe wapis kyun baat, bahut acha lag raha hai. Ye dekhiye, now, okay, we begin. Now, these are my early pictures, you know, these close-ups. You see, when you're young and when you're new with the camera, you know, you see a thing and you attack, you take a picture. And here you see these gypsy girls, you know, the way light is falling. So, you know, the way I, the feeling I get when I'm taking a picture, I try to reproduce in terms of black and whites. So the sunshine falling on half page is exactly like that. And the other faces in the shadow, of course, you're here, you can't see the details because there's too much of light. So you go bang for a subject, you know, next. This is, you know, when my son was born and my father came to see him. So he was holding his hands and talking to him, you know. So I came, you know, right behind him, and I looked at these hands and I said, please put them together. So you can see the tenderness and the age, you know, the texture. You know, this is a photographic image. The difference between a photograph and an image, the difference between a snapshot and image, where everything gets transformed into some strength and energy, you know. Next thing. You know, sensuality, they say, you know, it's even the baby is can feel this, you know. So this is you know, today we are scared of so many things, you know, in expressing ourselves on so many levels. But look at the child. They are not scared of expressing themselves the way it comes to them. Next one. But these are my early pictures, bold and graphic. And I must tell you that, you know, when I was doing these kind of pictures, people thought I was doing very good work. And when I started expanding my horizon, starting relating to the larger space and world, people said, thought, you know, main bikhar raha hun. But I'll talk about that, you know, later. Chaliye, next. Aage badhaiye. this is a refugee from Bangladesh, you know, this was after the rain, and you can see the water patches, you know, even those lines and patches that form a composition, and yet the expression of the lady is so intense, you know. Next. This is an army band, you know, playing on the Republic Day, and the dome of the Rashtrapati Bhavan, and that instrument, the roundness, if you see it, as if it's just, you know, come out of that kind of an experience. Next one. You know, these, the creative aspect of any medium is just a little nudge, just a little whisper. You know, it's not 2 + 2 - 1 is this much. It's just the feeling, just a whisper. You know, you walk through the street sometimes, you know, suddenly you feel something, you know, and you say, how nice. But you don't calculate, you don't put into words, you just get a feeling and walk across. And that feeling remains in your, you know, memory for a long time, you know. Chaliye, next. This is when President Zakir Hussain died, you know, it was a hot day. And this, one of the soldier was standing for too many hours and he fainted over there, you know. And you can see the, this is, now you see, I do believe in one thing, that when you make yourself available physically, mentally and spiritually, then nature helps you. And when nature sees this child has been at it for a long time, then nature opens up such avenues, such interesting magical moments that you can never even think of, you know. I saw these sparrows on a roadside. Ye dana bicha hua hai, wo kha rahi hai. I come with a camera, I stand there and I focus. And I stand there and I say, well, they look interesting, but nothing is happening. And then suddenly this blackbird lands there. And if you see, notice carefully, the space the sparrows have left around this bird. And I take a picture and the bird goes away. Now, your connection with the nature and with the magic moment has to happen simultaneously. And then nature gives it to you. And the next moment is again as flat, as ordinary as ever. But these things come and go. This is touch and go, you know. There is no explanation, no details about it, and no stories, you know. Next. And the next. You see, you must have seen many photographs of old men, but if you look at the structure of this old man and his arms, is very sculptorous looking. And so is that drum, you know, the way the tummy of the drum has been cut, you know. So I used to put together these two images, one after another, you know. The next. This is again, I think, maybe must have been in Yogjoy's village, you know, walking through the streets, you know, this patch of liquid coming out of a strange door, you know. Creativity is about capturing the mystery of things, you know, or revealing the mystery of things. Everything else can be informative or pretty or whatever, but pretty situations are just pretty. Actually, I must tell you something, you know, my friend Diwan Manna, who's a very sensitive human being and a very loving friend, so I'm staying with him, you know. And so he gave me his own bedroom and he made sure that I was very comfortable, and it seems apparently he's brought a new set of towels for me. And beautiful green, which I have never seen before, and the edge is beautiful green on this towel. And you look at the towel, you feel how beautiful. You want to use it or you want to see it. And then, so after I had my bath, I started, you know, cleaning up, and discovered, because it's new, because it's beautiful, it doesn't have any other expression so far. It doesn't soak the water. And this is the problem about most beautiful surfaces in this world. You know, and it was amazing for me, you know, that how everything has so much to, you know, connect with and understand why this. And it doesn't soak. Similarly, a new mind, a young mind, only looks at physical stuff and physical beauty, but doesn't soak in and doesn't become a proper towel. You know, for anything in life, you know, you have to perform the duty of being that plus more. So everything else has to join in together to make a very wholesome, rich experience, you know. Chaliye next wala. This is also one of my early landscapes. But dekhiye aap isme texture jo hai, insano ka, janvaron ka, carts ka, dharti jo hai na, uspe jo human imprint hai. Chaliye. This picture is one of my very early pictures, but wherever in the world it has gone for an exhibition and a competition in museums, it gets published. And when I took it, you know, you see the difference is early years when I started taking pictures, most of the time, now I can tell you that used to be again instinctive, you know, that this looks very strange and interesting, you know, and no calculations and no concept and no preconceived ideas. And then I discovered that this photograph captures an India which is eternal. This could have been taken 200 years ago, you know. And this is one quality. Now, when I am not a serious photographer and I'm just playing around with the camera, I've got no baggage to carry as a professional photographer or as a creative photographer. So I'm interacting absolutely freely and without any problem, without any challenges. And most of the time, you know, then you have no extra baggage and everything is happening for you because it's your instinct at play. And when instinct tells you or gives you a nudge, the magic happens and the picture remains eternal. Next, please. This is again, you know, in one of the rural areas in Delhi, you know, children, I used to call it junior bullfight, you know, they were chasing this little calf, you know, and having fun. Next, please. This is outside the Birla Mandir. You can see the old men and the their sticks and the vertical forms of the Mandir. They are in a kind of an alignment. Chaliye. You see, I have just finished editing my book on Delhi. Now, this picture was taken about 40 years ago, when I say photo history of our time. And today, when you go behind the Samayu's tomb in Delhi, it does not exist the same way. Things have changed so drastically, but look at this world, you know, which is so amazing. And this is how the world is changing so fast. So photographic sensitive record of things has a lot of value about it, you know. Chaliye next. This is a picture that I had taken while sitting in a car waiting for a friend. And the cot and the crow and the part of this car, which is right in the middle of the frame, is in a reflection in the back view mirror. Sometimes what happens, you're physically sitting here, but your mind is somewhere else. And if your physicality and your mind's image, if you merge together, you know, it will create very strange image, you know. But it's one straight photograph. Dekhiye kehte hain, plant trees because they retain water. This is a flash flood near Jaipur and this was taken in a helicopter. And you can see, apart from being beautiful, a very beautiful looking landscape, it also shows, you know, how the water is retained closer to the trees, you know, wherever the trees are, you know. Chaliye. Ye Nekchand ji ka hai. क्योंकि नेकचंद जी की जो फॉर्म्स बड़ी फोकिश होती हैं और उनके अजीब अजीब सी फॉर्म्स और फनी एक्सप्रेशंस और सब उनकी दुनिया वो अपनी क्रिएट करते हैं, तो मैंने देखा जो बादल है ना वो भी वैसे ही थे, तो सारे मिलके बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग फ्रेम बनता था. चलिए ये देखिए, इस जो ये इमेज है इसको मैं सोचता हूँ कि उसकी देन है कि जब आप मेहनत करते हैं, करते जाते हैं, तब नेचर कहती है कि ये ले बेटे, ये भी है तेरे लिए. कि मैं शाम को, हमारे एक मुस्लिम दोस्त हैं दिल्ली में, वो हमें ले गए कि हमारे रिज से, हमारे घर से आप देखिए जामा मस्जिद कैसी लगती है. तो मैं घंटा भर, दो घंटे भर वहाँ फोटोज़ खींचता रहा. खींच के जब अंधेरा होने लगा, लाइटें जल गईं, तो मैंने कहा चलो नीचे उतरते हैं. जो ही मैं नीचे उतरने लगा, मैंने सामने देखा घर में ये एक लेडी नमाज पढ़ रही हैं, जामा मस्जिद सिटी, और जो क्लाउड्स भी हैं उनमें भी देखिए कितनी इंटेंसिटी है. So these are godsend. You cannot visualize them, you can't preconceive them, you cannot create them. It's a nature's, you know, magical gift to you in moments if you make yourself available and you are ready to grab it. Chaliye. This is migrant labor in Calcutta, but see the energy, the interaction, you know, everything going on in every direction. Chaliye, next, chaliye. This is at the burning ghats. You know, these days I do use a lot of panoramic cameras, you know. I'll explain this also. I was crossing a bridge sitting in a car, and if you see the clouds, the dockyard, the boats, you know, this is again, could have been taken maybe 200 years ago, 300 years ago, but going, you know, traveling in a car, and suddenly I see this and I click a picture with nature's blessings. It's sharp, clean, and clicked at the right moment. You know, how energies connect and create inner discipline for everything to come into rhythm, in place, in those moments, you know. Chaliye. This is Imambara, which is the most beautiful architecture and structures, you know, on so many levels. But see the condition and see the boys, you know, how they are people, you know, we behave with these great heritage. This is, you know, the husband and wife, they were pushing the cart. And I found it very interesting. So I kept chasing them, walking with them, you know. And till suddenly, you know, they reached this place with the building next to it, and the whole frame, the boxes of the building, they become one huge form. And this lady's movement and action energizes the whole space, you know. And I remember first time when I met Mr. Satyajit Ray, whose films I admired a great deal. He says, Raghu, I can't forget that image I saw in one of the exhibitions. Can I have a print? And I felt very proud about it. That you see how we meet. I must tell you something, you know, I'm doing a book on Indian classical musicians. And, you know, there was time when I wanted to become a musician. And my father said, kya hai? Mirasi banungi kya? You know, this expression, hamare Punjabi to sabhi jante hain, ki mirasi kya hote hain. But he, maybe he didn't want me to do anything else than engineering. And when my elder brother was a photographer, when I became a photographer, he used to tell people, haan, mere char bete the, do photographer ho gaye hain. Like they've gone photographers. Till, you know, the world started recognizing photography, and India also, first time they gave Padma Shri to a photographer, then suddenly everything fell in place, and my father thought, you know, my sons were doing very well, you know. Chaliye, next dikhai. Ye dekhiye, ye lagta desert hai, par ye Lakshadweep hai. Jab wahan pe low tide hoti hai, to samundar chala jata hai wapis. Aur you can see that patch of cloud being reflected in the landscape also. Here you can see the forms and colors and the clouds and the, you know, life around Marine Drive. This is Calcutta, Hooghly River. And you can see the morning activities and the whole mood of the space is, you know, very wholesome experience. Next. You see, like now you see, they say a picture must tell a story. Now, stories have been told and retold, you know. And then they say a good picture is worth a thousand words. You see, these are, after a while, they all become cliches in an art form. When you say a good picture is worth a thousand words, may I say that a thousand words can be a lot of noise. How about some silence? कहते हैं कि भगवान बुद्ध जब उनको ज्ञान हो गया तो किसी एक गांव में उन्होंने जाना था लोगों से मिलने के लिए तो भगवान बुद्ध के इंतजार में वहां उनके लिए जगह सजाई हुई थी और हजारों लोग इकट्ठे होते जा रहे थे तो भगवान बुद्ध जो हैं वो लेट हो गए पहुंचने में तो ये होता है कि पब्लिक जब इकट्ठी हो जाती है तो सब बातें करने लगते हैं तो चारों तरफ बातें हो रही हैं शोर है और चल रहा है शोर तो अचानक जब भगवान बुद्ध आए तो वो आके बैठे जब वो बैठे तो जो लोगों ने जो देखते गए साइलेंस ट्रेवल करनी शुरू हुई. जो सामने वालों ने देखा उनमें खामोशी आई, जो उसके बाद लोग देखते गए सब में साइलेंस जो है ट्रेवल करने लगी. वो इतना बड़ा क्राउड जो था सारे में साइलेंस रिस्टोर हो गई. तो भगवान बुद्ध कहते हैं वहां बैठे रहे, उनको किसी ने एक फूल दिया, उन्होंने फूल लिया, फूल को चूमा, सबको देखा, रख दिया और सब देख रहे हैं साइलेंस में और भगवान बुद्ध भी सबको निहार रहे हैं और बैठे रहे और निहारते रहे और निहारते रहे. और फिर जब पूरी साइलेंस सब में रिस्टोर हो गई उन्होंने सर झुकाया और चल दिए. देखिए कि ये अजीब अजीब फिलॉसफीज और आइडियाज हैं अबाउट आर्ट, अबाउट गुरु. गुरु इज द वन हु रिस्टोर्स साइलेंस इन यू एंड अ ग्रेट वर्क ऑफ आर्ट और ग्रेट पीस ऑफ म्यूजिक और अ ग्रेट मूवी इज द वन आफ्टर सीइंग इट और लिसनिंग टू दैट म्यूजिक आई डोंट वॉन्ट any questions, I don't have any questions, I don't want to know, I don't want to interact with anybody, and it has restored complete silence in me, it has fulfilled me as a human being. And that is the purpose also of any good art work, you know. So, you know, all these cliches, 1,000 words and blah blah, you know, and stories have to be told. Why stories? The ordinary daily lives have so much of rhythm and magic happening, you know. You look at the dhatuns, all those three dhatuns are in certain rhythm and alignment with the lines of the and the forms, and look at the color quality of the blue all around it, you know. So this is going beyond storytelling images, you know. Next chaliyega. ये दिल्ली में अक्षरधाम बना है. मैं ये कहूँगा कि आफ्टर 10 centuries वी बिल्ट अ टेम्पल ऑफ दिस साइज एंड क्राफ्ट्समैनशिप विच इज़ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. बट लुक एट द साधुस, दे वॉक इन एंड लुक एट द आईज, यू नो, एंड द इंटेंसिटी इन देयर आईज, इवन दे कांट बिलीव इट, यू नो. चलिए नेक्स्ट. ये इसका कैप्शन है dust storm created by a VIP helicopter. ये सच बात है. इंदिरा जी राजस्थान drought affected areas में गई थी तो अचानक उनको खबर मिली कि किसी प्रेसिडेंट की डेथ हो गई थी या क्या था, तो उनको सडनली हेलीकॉप्टर भेजा गया और उनको वहां से बुलवाया गया. तो जब उनका हेलीकॉप्टर उड़ा तो वो सबकी आंखों में खूब धूल और मिट्टी डालते हुए गया और मैं भी ये 2 frame क्लिक कर पाया और उसके बाद मुझे भी कुछ नहीं दिखाई दिया. पर जो 2 थे वो आज डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी में मैंने उनको साथ मिला दिया है. और ये देखिए उसकी इंटेंसिटी देखिए और उसका फील देखिए, जैसे सब फिगर्स किसी ने ब्रश से इंटेंसिटी भर दी हो. चलिए ये पैनोरामिक्स जो हैं, अब ये देखिए ये वर्टिकल पैनोरामिक नीचे से लेके ऊपर तक, और इसकी अगर आप डिटेल्स देखें, जो पहला आदमी सोया उसके नीचे जो सराहना है, उस पर जो पैटर्न और फूल हैं, ये सारी चीज़ें दे आर ऑल इंटर रिलेटेड. एंड द शिव टेम्पल एंड द बॉय वॉकिंग इन एंड ऑल दोज फिगर्स अबव इट, यू नो. द नेक्स्ट वन लेट्स सी, दिस इज ऑल्सो कैलकटा, यू नो, द रूट्स ऑफ द ट्री एंड द लिम्स ऑफ द human beings, you know, there's a kind of a rhythm and relationship, you know. Next dikhaye, ye Varanasi mein ek mandir mein shlokas ka uchcharan karte hue. Chaliye ye dekhiye Calcutta street ka hai. Main is panoramic ke bare mein aapko ye batana cha raha tha ki ye double two, it takes larger than normal frame. To jab main France mein exhibit kar raha tha, unhone mujhse pucha के यू why have you know concentrated so much on these panoramics, is there any special reason? Now you see the reason that I found over the years that you see in any art form, especially photography, which is a Western medium and Western photographers popularized it and we also got it here, we started learning, and the idea was, the concept was capturing a moment in time. So there are thousands of good photographers in this world who captured millions of moments in space, you know. So there comes a saturation point, you know, a moment in space, a moment in space, a moment in space. I said, India is a multi-religious society. India is a multicultural society. India has got Himalayas, India has got deserts, India has got backwaters and valleys, and India has got so many cultural diversities and costumes and everything else. Apart from that, India, being an ancient civilization, lives on so many levels of different centuries living at the same time. So the experience of India has to be multi-layered. A moment in space is not enough for India. In my images, I like to have a moment here and a moment there and a moment there and maybe much more later, if I can grab it, you know. तो देखिए ये बात ये आती है कि आपके अंदर कितनी प्यास है कि मैंने इतना देखा जब मैं जवान था मैं उतने में खुश हुआ जब मुझे थोड़ी समझ आई तो मैंने कहा अरे इसके आसपास दुनिया भी तो है तो मैंने इतना देखा जब मुझे और थोड़ी समझ आई तो मैंने कहा दुनिया इतनी बड़ी क्यों नहीं है अगर आप सच पूछे ना अगर मेरा बस चले तो मैं एक क्लिक में पूरे देश की एनर्जी और मैजिक को कैप्चर कर लूँ जो कभी हो ही नहीं सकता So I must go on. But nevertheless, the more you demand from yourself and the more you open up, the world is waiting for you to be captured, you know. कि हमें जो ये अक्सर आइडिया होता है कि अरे इतना हमने कर लिया काफी है अगर आपकी तसल्ली उसी में है तो काफी है आप गरीबी में जीना चाहते हैं आप गरीबी में जियो दुनिया में इतनी रिचनेस है ट्रेजर्स हैं हिंदुस्तान इज अ पैराडाइज फॉर एनी फोटोग्राफर To grab so much in any given time, you know. So this is the magic of this country, where I hopefully need to do it with, you know, this digital technology being giving you more freedom and more ease to capture much more than ever before. Hopefully, you know, the journey will go on. Next, please. ये देखिए, ये नाथ नथैया फेस्टिवल वाराणसी में है. And I am just barely 4 feet away from the crowds, but none of them is looking at me. And look at the intensity of their expressions and the architecture and people everywhere, you know. And it's a very sharp. You see, my belief is that we say we capture reality. When we say we capture reality, two things must happen, you know. Next. That A, the human eye sees everything in focus. B, everything should be in proper perspective. We can't distort things, you know. Now look at this, you know, the texture, the expression of the elephant. And below him, you can see the Pushkar fair. Now what happens in Pushkar fair when they come and they come to buy and sell the camels, they open their mouth, they see their teeth, and then they decide the quality and the life of this camel. So here they are opening, and look at the expression of the camel, you know, as if he is, you know, making fun at them or laughing at them, you know. So this is the magic, you know, about this picture, you know. Chaliye, next. This is on Varanasi Ghats, you know, where they burn their deads, but you can see the energy and the mood of the people. And this man standing on the right, you know, the way his hand is, you know, my wife also said, you know, you men are so stupid, you always stand like this, you know. So, you know, which confirms that this reality is a very common thing. Chaliye, next, chaliye. Ye bhi dekhiye, wo jo daant apne saaf kar raha hai, kitna uska funny expression hai, plus wo sara crowd or garbage niche, everything, you know, falls into a kind of wholesome rhythm, you know. Chaliye. हाँ ये कुमार जी हैं जिन्होंने आपने आप में से जिन्होंने कुमार जी को सुना हो तो उनकी बिल्कुल आवाज़ समझ में आने लगती कि वो क्या हो रहे होंगे देखिए उनकी एनर्जी देखिए उनके हाथों में वो एक्सप्रेशन देखिए नेक्स्ट वाला देखें मैं अपने जो क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियंस हैं उन पे बुक कर रहा हूँ तो कई जगह तो मैंने इंटरप्रिटेटिव इमेज बनाया है जैसे ये के जो एस बालचंद्र वीणा बजाते थे कर्नाटक संगीत के आप में से कईयों ने सुना होगा उनके स्ट्रोक्स जो होते थे वो इतने डीप के जो सरोद है उससे भी ज़्यादा डेप्थ उसमें और एनर्जी है और ये एक एक स्ट्रोक को फिर प्रोलॉन्ग करते थे और उसको कितने लेवल्स पे लेके जाते थे तो मैंने बालचंद्र जी को कहा कि हम चलें Mahabalipuram, because he was in Madras mein hi rehte the, and he was nice enough, so we went to Mahabalipuram. There are many rocks, many of you must have seen them. Now, I made him sit there, and I walked back, but the, you know, the way I was visualizing that this is the kind of image I'll take, but the position, the way I put him there and I get back, I discover this is not what I wanted. But I said, wait a minute, this is not what you wanted, but look at the experience now, which is much more stronger. You know, this rock, I couldn't include the complete rock, but the texture and the size of the rock. And then, as I said, when you make yourself available to the situations, nature creates magic for you. You look at the clouds, the way they are going up, and look at the four people walking behind it. You see, the other day somebody was asking me, you know, in Bombay we had a photography workshop, saying that, you know, it seems that your photographs have certain kind of rhythm and music about them. Each one of us, we have certain music plays in our heads, in our minds, in our spirits, in our energies. Sabke andar koi na koi music bajta hai. Aur jab aapke paas ek medium hai express karne ko, to wo rhythm jo hai, unconsciously, when different elements move in different directions, your inner rhythm and the elements outside, they come into certain rhythm. And that is your personal journey, your personal approach to photography. And that's where each one of us can have our own rhythm, our own style of doing things. As long as we don't act from the programmed mind. Now this again, I'll say, your personal rhythm is not the programming. It's the inner music that keeps playing in the spirit. And when that spirit connects with the energies, with the elements outside, they form certain rhythm. Next chaliyega. Ye bhi interpretative hai. Ab ye ke ye unke ghar ke paas jahan Hari Prasad ji rehte hain. Maine kaha aaiye chalte hain, ghoomne nikalte hain. Inki aapko ek bhi aur bhi badi achhi kahani sunaunga. To ye badal dekhiye, wo jo badalon ki line hai aur unki flute ki line hai, wo to ek rhythm hua. Ab niche dekhiye, rock ke niche jo ripples hain, ye sara ek apni tarah ka music hai nature ka. और यहाँ पे मैं उनको एज सिंबल यूज करके वो सारे रिदम में, नेचर के रिदम में एक अपनी तरह का राग का फील आना चाहिए. इज माय फीलिंग, यू नो, दैट्स द वे आई लुक एट इट. चलिए, एक सिख गुरु हैं जो अमेरिका में रहते हैं, तो वो कहते हैं कि वो एक सज्जन मिले उनको, जो कहते हैं उनके तीन बेटे हैं जवान, बहुत अच्छा बिजनेस करते हैं और बहुत पैसा है उनके पास और वो बहुत पाठ करते हैं, लेकिन फिर भी उनकी तसल्ली नहीं है. तो जो ये गुरु थे, उन्होंने उनसे पूछा कि पाठ दिल में करते हो या बोल के करते हो. उसने कहा, जी बोल के करता हूं. तो उन्होंने पूछा कि कभी खुद भी सुना है उसको. देखिए कि जो आप ये एक्सप्रेशन तो जानते हैं, प्लेइंग टू द गैलरी. जब आप अपने लिए नहीं नाचते हैं, जब आप अपने लिए नहीं गाते हैं, जब आप आनंदित नहीं होते अंदर से, तो गैलरी भी जो है ना, वो ऐसे ही चली जाएगी. ये मोमेंट जो है, ये मल्लिकार्जुन मंसूर जो बड़े ही संत फकीर आदमी थे, ये देखिए, अब ये वहां की आवाज से कनेक्टेड है, उससे सुन रहे हैं और फिर शायद गाएंगे. ये जो साइलेंस, द स्पेस इन बिटवीन दैट बिकम्स साइलेंट एंड कनेक्ट्स टू द अदर एनर्जीज एंड देन यू गेट इट फ्रॉम देयर, दैट पावर. ये कनेक्शन क्रिएटिविटी में बहुत कीमती है. आगे चलिए जी, ये देखिए पंडित भीमसेन जोशी हमारे, इनका कमाल ये देखिए कि उनकी गायकी जो है ना, इतनी फिजिकली उनको एग्जर्ट करना पड़ता है कि अब वो एज के साथ वो इतनी आसानी से वैसे नहीं गा सकते हैं, तो ये फ्रेम मैंने टेढ़ा नहीं किया है, वो गाते गाते यूं घूम गए। ये किशोरी जी व्हेन शी इज गुड शी इज अनबिलीवेबल, तब ऐसे लगता है कि उसकी ब्लेसिंग्स हम पे शावर कर रही है, इतनी उनमें भक्ति और तपस्या है जब वो गुस्सा में नहीं होती हैं तो। और देखिए उनकी जो सारी इंटेंसिटी इनके यहाँ रगों में, जैसे गालिब कहते थे ना, रगों में दौड़ने फिरने के हम नहीं कायल, जो आंख ही से न टपके वो फिर लहू क्या है। तो ये ऐसे लोग हैं। और वो जो गालिब की ये बात जो है ना, देखिए कि लिखते तो सभी हैं, फोटोग्राफी तो बड़े लोग करते हैं, गाते तो बहुत लोग हैं, पर किनका कहां से क्या इंटेंसिटी टपकती है, इज व्हाट दैट इज द मैजिकल एनर्जी यू नो वे यू मेक अ डिफरेंस। चलिए और नेक्स्ट भी दिखाइए, दोनों का एक्सप्रेशन देखिए क्या इंटेंसिटी है। वो मेरे एक दोस्त कहते हैं दिस इज एन ऑर्गेजम यू नो यू लीव इट असाइड, यू नो वापस जाइए। देखिए स्पेशल जाकिर हुसैन को देखिए, लुक एट बिस्मिल्लाह खान साहब, अब वो पीछे की लाइंस और पैचेस जो हैं और उनकी एक्सप्रेशन, ही वॉज अ वार्म अफेक्शनेट मैन, यू कैन फील दैट, एंड द वे ही इज होल्डिंग हिज शहनाई, वो उंगलियों का फील भी जो है कितना टेंडर है। ये छोटी छोटी बातें जो हैं दे एड टू द एक्सप्रेशन एंड स्ट्रेंथ। नेक्स्ट चलिए, ये लोग दिल्ली में जहाँ मैं रहता था वहाँ पे हमारा घर पेंट करने आए, तो 5-6 दिन तक ये हमारा घर पेंट कर रहे थे और मैं इनकी शक्लें देखता था, मैं कहता था कितने भोले वाले कितने अच्छे इंसान हैं, तो मुझसे रहा नहीं गया। फिर मैंने एक दिन इनको सबको बिठा के इनकी तस्वीरें खींची और देखिए पूरे के पूरे वहाँ हैं। कई दफ़े होता है ना, आप किसी को मिलते हैं, आप कहते हैं अरे आपसे मिल के बहुत आनंदित हुए, क्यों, क्योंकि वो साक्षात आपके सामने, वो मेंटली फिजिकली इनसाइड आउटसाइड दे आर सो कम्प्लीटली ट्रांसपेरेंट एंड देयर फॉर यू एंड यू मीट देम, और आपको जो उनके दर्शन होते हैं तो आपको लगता है कि क्या बात है। तो ये ऐसे लोग थे। चलिए, ये मेरी मदर हैं, आप सबकी भी होंगी हैं फॉर श्योर, पर ये देखिए कि जब ये कनेक्ट करती हैं तो क्या इनकी सारे रिंकल्स में भी जो है मैजिक दिखाई देता है। मैं आपको बताऊं कि मदर को मैं फोटोग्राफ कर रहा था 1970 में, पहली बार जब मैं गया तो 3-4 दिन के बाद मदर मुझे कहती कि आप कल मत आना। मैंने कहा क्यों मदर, कहती नहीं टुमारो इज ईस्टर डे एंड आई डोंट वांट एनी फोटोग्राफर्स टू बी वॉन्डरिंग अराउंड एंड डिस्टर्बिंग द प्रेयर्स। So, you know, I was absolutely devastated. I said, oh my God, you know, how can she say that, you know? So I took a deep breath and I said, Mother, but you say two things are important to you. One is that you serve the poorest of the poor, because when Christ was suffering, you were not there to nurse him. And when you nurse these poorest of the poor, you think you are nursing the Christ, which is a very beautiful thought. And second thing, when you do this, you do your prayers to make a connection with him, to rejuvenate yourself. She says, yes. I said, Mother, I have done one part of the story, that you serving the poorest of the poor and loving them and taking care of them. But when you sit in prayer, and if I don't do that photograph, I said, I have never met him, who that guy is. But I know for sure, when you sit in prayer, he lands in your eyes. And if you don't let me do that, my experience is going to be incomplete. So mother looked at me. The best part about mother was that she will, I won't say looked at me, she looked into me. You know, her eyes were so warm, loving and piercing. कि कभी कभी जब माँ अंदर झांकती थी ना तो डर लग जाता था कि तो सारा देख लेती है, ऐसा लगता था। देखिए ये बात जो है बड़ी कीमती है कि अंदर तक पहुंच जाती थी, तो अंदर पहुंच के कहती है ठीक है विद वन कंडीशन दैट यू विल नॉट मूव फ्रॉम वन प्लेस। आई सेड ऑल राइट मदर, that's your promise. I said, yes, mother. She says, come tomorrow at 6 o'clock. I go there at 6 in the morning. Mother says, yeah, you've come. Good, very good. Let's walk up. We go to the chapel. It was almost double the size of this. So there was a priest over there and a statue of the Christ. All the sisters were there. And we walk in. Mother sits down there. She says, you sit down there. I said, all right, mother. I sit down there. And mother gets into prayers. I start taking pictures, slowly sitting at one place. And when she goes into meditation now, I am getting just not even the profile properly. Because she ordered me to sit there, so I had to sit there. I sit down. And then she goes into meditation, from prayer to meditation, and I can see the connection, I can see the intensity, but I can't move. And being a photographer, if I don't have the right angle, what do I do? So I am restless and uneasy, and finally I get up, I go right in front of the mother, I take my pictures, come away. And then after another half an hour, when the prayers are over, all the sisters are walking up to the priest and they are kissing the feet of the Christ statue, you know. And then mother gets up. And the distance is about 20 feet, 30 feet, you know. So mother gets up, I am sitting here, the promise is made. So after she's taken few steps, I can't resist. I also get up, I follow her, I take the pictures. She comes out from the other door, I walk out from this door. And then it was a time of, you know, confrontation or whatever. So I go to mother, I said, mother, I'm very sorry, please forgive me, I couldn't keep my promise. अब देखिए जो संत लोग होते हैं क्या होते हैं. मैं यूं हाथ किया, मैंने कहा मदर फॉरगिव मी. वो मेरे दोनों हाथ, दोनों हाथों से पकड़ी, बोलती हैं, गॉड हैज गिवन यू दिस असाइनमेंट, यू मस्ट डू इट वेल. एंड आई कुडंट बिलीव इट. आई मीन ये हैं संत फकीर लोग जो अंदर से कनेक्टेड सोल्स हैं कि गॉड हैज गिवन यू दिस असाइनमेंट, यू मस्ट डू इट वेल. तो उसके बाद मेरा मदर से जो कनेक्शन था बिल्कुल बदल चुका था. चलिए ये देखिए, सनशाइन माँ के पैरों को छू के जा रही है और कितनी सुंदर माँ लगती है. एक बात मैं आपको और बताना चाहूंगा कि मैं भले ही हिंदू फैमिली में हुआ, मेरा धर्म फोटोग्राफी है. और मैं जब मंदिर जाता हूँ तो मैं हिंदू हूँ, जब मैं हरमंदिर साहब जाता हूँ तो मैं पूरी तरह से उतना ही सिख भगत बन के जाता हूँ, और जब मैं मस्जिद में जाता हूँ तो मैं एक अच्छे मुसलमान का फील लेना चाहूँगा. क्योंकि हमारे हिंदुस्तान में ये तो कितनी फ़ायदे की बात है कि हमारे यहाँ सब ऑल द गॉड्स आर अवेलेबल टू अस एंड वी कैन चूज डिफरेंट गॉड्स एट डिफरेंट टाइम्स. ओ अल्लाह टेक केयर, for Christ's sake, please help me, you know. So everybody is there for us. चलिए ये देखिए, माँ के हाथ जो थे ना वो पिघल जाते थे बच्चों की बॉडी के हिसाब से, ऐसे मुड़ जाते थे जैसे रबड़ के हों. और आंखों में एक्सप्रेशन देखिए मदर के, ये भी जैसा क्राइस्ट का एक्शन है वैसा ही मदर का एक्शन है. वो सिस्टर्स, ऑल द सिस्टर्स आर वेटिंग, इट्स लुकिंग अनशार्प. चलिए नेक्स्ट. ये मदर के चले जाने के बाद ये वही जगह है जहाँ की मैं आपको कहानी बता रहा था. पर ये मदर का स्टैचू है, उसी पोस्चर में बनाया है जैसे मदर बैठा करती थी, और जहाँ बैठा करती थी वहीं रखा हुआ स्टैचू है. एंड द सिस्टर्स आर इन प्रेयर, बट इट ऑलमोस्ट लुक्स लाइक मदर इज ऑल्सो सिटिंग देयर. तो देखिए, मैं आपको कुछ छोटे छोटे एक्सपीरियंसेस आपसे शेयर कर दूँ कि मैं संगीत पर कारों को फोटोग्राफ करते करते कैलिफोर्निया चला गया, अली अकबर खान साहब के वहाँ. अली अकबर खान साहब का वहाँ पे स्कूल है म्यूज़िक का, और मैं ये सोचता हूँ कि अली अकबर खान इज़ अ म्यूजिशियन ऑफ म्यूजिशियंस, यू नो, ही इज़ सच अ ग्रैंड मास्टर ऑफ म्यूजिशियंस, यू नो. और उनकी रीच और इंटेंसिटी जो है, ही प्लेज टूडे विद years of yesterday's experience, and each stroke has the years of experience of yesterday and today's urgency and need and expression and tomorrow's possibilities. He has such magic power. तो मैं वहाँ चला गया, तो खान साहब जो बड़े serious लगते हैं अक्सर हर concert में, और आसानी से मुस्कुराते भी नहीं हैं, तो he was so wonderful and loving. He asked me, kahan thehre hain? Maine kaha, ji ye hotel mein thehra hu. Kehte, koi nahi. Kal jab aap aayein, to sara saman leke aayi, aap mere saath thehrenge. I thought, how wonderful of him. So, sham ko, jab unki class wagara aur sara din ka kaam khatam hua, kehne lage, chaliye, ab ghar chalte hain, hamare ghar chaliye, I'll cook for you. I said, how wonderful, Khan sahab, I'll certainly come with you. So, I went to him, went to his place, met his wife, his children, and then, you know, he started asking me, ke, aap to kafi sangeet ke baare mein jaante honge. तो अब बड़ी मुश्किल बनी कि कैसे बताऊं कि मैं क्या जानता हूं और क्या नहीं. तो मैंने कहा, खान साहब, ऐसा है कि मैं कुछ राग तो पहचान सकता लेकिन मुझे बहुत सारे सुरों का ज्ञान नहीं है. तो खान साहब का चेहरा जो था, थोड़ी डिसअपॉइंटमेंट लगी कि इतनी दूर ये बंदा आ गया है और कुछ जानता नहीं है म्यूज़िक के बारे में. तो जब मैंने उनकी आँखों में ये देखा, तो मैंने कहा, खान साहब, एक बात आपको बताऊँ कि मैं रसिक बड़ा अच्छा हूँ. तो खान साहब की थोड़ी आंखें खुली और उनमें क्वेश्चन आया कि भाई ये रसिक बड़ा अच्छा है कि क्या रसिक अच्छा है. तो मैंने कहा, खान साहब, 1970 में मैंने क्लासिकल म्यूज़िक सुनना शुरू किया और ऐसा हुआ कि जो मैंने पहला एलपी खरीदा वो देश मल्हार था, आपका बजाया हुआ. तो कहते, हाँ वो बहुत पुराना देश मल्हार मैंने बजाया था. तो मैंने कहा, खान साहब, जब मैं कोई मुझे संगीत अच्छा लगता है तो मैं उसको बार बार सुनता हूँ, बार बार सुनता हूँ. और मैंने कहा, स्पेशली जब रात को सब सो जाते हैं तब अकेले में सुनता हूँ, क्योंकि मैं ये चाहता हूँ कि वो मेरे माइंड में ही नहीं, मेरी रगों में भी, मेरी बोन्स को भी नर्चर करता है. मुझे ऐसा आनंद आता है. तो मैंने कहा, मैं आज ही रात को आपका देश मल्हार सुन रहा था. तो सुनते सुनते मुझे ये ऐसे आनंद का एक्सपीरियंस हुआ कि खान साहब, आप जो कह रहे हैं 100% पूरा कह रहे हैं. मैंने कहा, ना मैं आपको जानता था ना मैं आपके राग को जानता था, पर सुनते सुनते जब वो रच गया तो मुझे ऐसा लगा कि आप 100% पूरा उसका एक्सपीरियंस दे रहे हैं. तो तब खान साहब के आधे चेहरे पे एक स्माइल आई. तो कहने लगे, क्या सुनेंगे? मैंने कहा, खान साहब, वो संगीत जो आप यूरोप में बजाते रहे और हमने नहीं सुना. तो उन्होंने काफ़ी सुनाया. तो बढ़िया खाना बनाया उन्होंने, बहुत बढ़िया गोश्त बनाया, चिकन करी भी बनाया, उनके साथ शिवाज रीगल भी बैठ के पी, जो उनका फेवरेट ड्रिंक था, और तब तक पी जब तक वो भी पिए और हम भी क्योंकि तब अच्छा नहीं लगता कि आप कहें अब नहीं और पीऊंगा जी. तो खैर, और इतने कमाल के वो इंसान के मुझे कहते हैं, चलो अब मैं आपको आपके होटल छोड़ दूं. अब जो मुद्दे की बात है वो ये है कि जब हम बाहर निकले तो मैंने देखा कि उनके फर्स्ट फ्लोर पर कंस्ट्रक्शन हो रही थी. तो मैंने कहा, खान साहब, ये आप क्या ऊपर एक दूसरी स्टोरी बना रहे हैं? कहते, नहीं नहीं नहीं, ये मेरा साउंड प्रूफ रूम होगा, जहाँ पे मैं, जहाँ कोई नहीं आएगा और जहाँ पे मैं प्ले किया करूँगा. मैंने कहा, वाह साहब, खान साहब, ये तो कमाल हो जाएगी. फिर मेरी तरफ मुड़ के, रुक के, देख के मुझे कहते हैं, और अगर सच्चा सुर लग गया तो तुम्हें भी सुनाऊंगा. कि वो खान साहब जो मुझे बड़े शक से और आनीजियों के देख रहे हैं कि इतनी दूर चला आया है और संगीत का कुछ नहीं जानता है, आज इतना कनेक्शन हो गया कि अगर सच्चा सिर लग गया तो तुमसे भी शेयर करूंगा. सच कहता हूं, जीना जो है ना, इतना ही सिंपल और इतना ही कमाल है कि जब आप उस लेवल पे कनेक्ट करते हैं तो सारे सुर बजने लगते हैं और सच्चे बजते हैं. तो ये जिंदगी की बातें हैं जो काफ़ी लेवल पे इतने सालों में मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि आई हैव लिव्ड ऑन दिस प्लैनेट फॉर मैनी सेंचुरीज एंड आई फील दैट वेल अ फ्यू मोर सेंचुरीज, फ्यू मोर इनिंग्स टू बी प्लेड, बट आई कैंट गो ऑन टॉकिंग बिकॉज आई एम नॉट दैट काइंड ऑफ अ लेक्चरर हु कैन गो ऑन सेइंग, बट आई प्रेफर यू नो इफ यू कैन इंटरेक्ट इफ देर इज एनी क्वेश्चन अबाउट एनीथिंग. देखिए, ऐसा है कि इट सो हैपन्स दिस वॉज सपोज टू मेंट टू बी वन आवर प्रोग्राम, और उसमें बहुत कुछ दिखाना पॉसिबल नहीं है. एक बात तो ये है. दूसरा, कलर फोटोग्राफी वर्सेस ब्लैक एंड वाइट फोटोग्राफी विच आई हैव एक्सपीरियंस्ड ओवर द इयर्स, व्हेन यू टेक अ कलर पिक्चर, व्हाट एवर कलर्स आर देयर, यू हैव टू टेक यू नो अ स्ट्रेट पिक्चर एंड यू कांट चेंज द कलर्स, एंड इन एनी गिवन सिचुएशन द डिफरेंट कलर्स दे मे नॉट जेल विद द मूड ऑफ द सेंस ऑफ द स्पेस, यू नो, एंड समटाइम्स it doesn't work out very well. But the moment you put a black and white filter on any given situation, it silences the noise of all the colors. So it works two ways. It's easier for the photographers, it's easier for the viewer also, because we want easy response, quick response. So it's very easy to look at a black and white image and relate to it, because different colors have different visual response, different colors have different emotional response, and they have to blend together in order to speak one language, like that picture of the blue picture of the Datuns and morning activities, you know, where everything blends and every line, every form blends with everything else. You know. Most of the time, as I said, programmed machines, we work from mind and we look for pictures and stories which are already designed and displayed in this world. But nobody is searching and nobody has that thirst and trust to explore other possibilities. So the picture should happen first and then you look at it. No, wait a minute, not even that. I'll say the world's greatest philosophies are born later on and put into words. First of all, it's a moment of exploration, interaction and discoveries that you walk through certain very intense experience of life and you've experienced it and it has enriched you and you come back and you say, oh my God, this is what it was. Then you put it into words and then it can become a philosophy. But if you read philosophy books and then go around looking for pictures, they will be just reproductions of some kind of information. ਮੈਂ ਇੱਕ ਬੜੀ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਜਿਹੀ ਗੱਲ ਸ਼ੇਅਰ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹਾਂਗਾ। ਮੇਰੀ ਮਦਰ ਜਦੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਛੋਟੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਤਾਂ ਇੱਕ ਗੱਲ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਕਿ ਆਪ ਨਾ ਮਰੀਏ ਅਤੇ ਸਵਰਗ ਨਾ ਜਾਈਏ। ਤਾਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਛੋਟੇ ਛੋਟੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ, ਅਸੀਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ, ਪਰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਪਤਾ ਸੀਗਾ ਇੰਸਟਿੰਕਟਿਵਲੀ ਕਿ ਕੋਈ ਬੜੀ ਖੂਬਸੂਰਤ ਗੱਲ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਆਪ ਨਾ ਮਰੀਏ ਅਤੇ ਸਵਰਗ ਨਾ ਜਾਈਏ। ਉਹ ਜੋ ਗਾਲਿਬ ਵੀ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਨਾ, ਇਹ ਆਗ ਕਾ ਦਰਿਆ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਡੂਬ ਕੇ ਜਾਣਾ ਹੈ, ਅਗਰ ਆਪ ਜਿਹਨੇ ਯੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਆ ਔਰ ਉਸਕੇ ਥਰੂ ਨਹੀਂ ਗਏ ਤੋ ਸਵਰਗ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਹੁੰਚਣੇ ਵਾਲੇ ਹੈ। ਦੇਖੀਏ ਇਨਕੀ ਇੰਟੈਂਸਿਟੀ ਔਰ ਇਨਕੀ ਬਾਤੇਂ ਵੀ ਔਰ ਉਨਕੀ ਐਨਰਜੀ ਵੀ ਦੇਖੀਏ ਕਿਤਨੀ ਕਮਾਲ ਕੀ ਹੈ, ਔਰ ਯੇ ਹੈ ਹਮਾਰੇ ਪੇ ਬਲੈਸਿੰਗਸ ਹਮਾਰੇ ਬੜੋ ਕੀ।
ਸਭ ਨੇ ਸੁਣਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਜੀਨੀਅਸਿਸ ਆਰ ਬੋਰਨ, तो भाई जीनियसेस आर बॉर्न विद अ स्टैम्प, तो आप सब की तो जरूरत ही नहीं इस दुनिया में, खेल ही खत्म हो गया आप सब के लिए और हमारे लिए, कि वो तो जीनियस स्टैम्प लगा के आए होते हैं। पर मैं आपको बताऊं कि मैंने पंडित रविशंकर जी, किशोरी जी, बड़े बड़े लोग, सत्यजीत रे, मदर, इन सब के साथ मैं इतना क्लोजली इनको फोटोग्राफ किया है, मैंने एक चीज नोटिस की है कि if at all the geniuses have to be born out of their guts, the ability to dedicate yourself 100% and all the time, you've reached a moment of genius, you've created a genius canvas or music or something which is unbelievable now, and you don't remain a genius. You have to be reborn the next moment to stay on that level of being a genius, and you have to be reborn out of your guts. Kyunki ye to duniya manti hai ki 80-90% it's lot of hard work and dedication. Hamare Hindustan mein kehte hain samarpit karna. Jab aap samarpit kar dete hain apne aap ko kisi ke liye, main aapko bataun ki aap kisi bhi bade musician ya kisi bhi bade genius ka naam lijiye, अगर उनसे उनकी कला एक तरफ रखवा लें और उनसे बात करें एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग, यू विल फाइंड देम वेरी ऑर्डिनरी ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। सिर्फ एक छोटी सी बात जो इंसान के बस की नहीं है कि समर्पित करना, डेडिकेट करना किसी पर्पस के लिए और टोटल डेडिकेशन में। आपने ये भी सुना होगा, हाँ वो पहले बहुत अच्छा बजाते थे लेकिन यार अब रेपिटेटिव हो गए, क्योंकि वो सबसे वाकिफ होके उन्होंने एक्सप्लोर करना, अपने गट से जीना बंद कर दिया तो वो सब निकल गया। तो देखिए कोई भी ठप्पा लगवा के कोई भी ऐसी क्वालिटी नहीं इस दुनिया में कि जिसको जिसके आप मालिक बन जाएं. अगर ऐसा होता तो सत्यजीत रे ने अपनी जीनियस अपने बेटे को हैंड ओवर कर दी होती. ये पॉलिटिक्स नहीं है, ये बिजनेस नहीं है कि जब इंदिरा जी ने अपने बेटे को आगे बढ़ा दिया या फलाने ने अपने बेटे को कर दिया या बिरला के आगे बिरला ने टेक ओवर कर लिया. ये वही है कि पर्सनल जर्नी है, ये आग का दरिया है और डूब के जाना है और हर मोमेंट में जाना है. और हजारों ख्वाहिशों की जो बात हुई थी जिसका हमने जिक्र नहीं किया है कि हर ख्वाहिश पे दम निकले और फिर अगली लाइन बहुत निकले मेरे अरमान लेकिन फिर भी कम निकले. क्यों? क्योंकि जितना उतनी ही बड़ी हसरत जितना ही उधर देता. आप जितना पाते हैं जितना जीते हैं उतना लगता है कि अरे यार अभी तो इतना कुछ करने वाला, अभी तो इतनी दुनिया एक्सप्लोर करने की पड़ी है. तो ये जो हसरत है और ऐसी ख्वाहिशें जो है वही तो इंसान की शान है. बाकी सब तो दुनिया चलती है, बिजनेस धंधा काम रिश्तेदारियां. और जो उस लेवल पे जी के नहीं गया कि वो एक गाना था ना, ये चांदनी रातें मुझे सोने नहीं देती. अब मैं आपको बताऊं कि आज भी हमारा जो फ्लैट है महरूली में थर्ड फ्लोर पे है और बहुत बड़े ग्लासेस लगे हुए हमारे बेडरूम में ड्राइंग रूम में, तो हम पर्दे हटाते हैं तो चांदनी रात अंदर चली आती है. और क्या क्या करती है आज भी. अब ये कहिए कि जी अब बहुत जी लिए चांदनी रातों में भी, अब क्या जरूरत है. देखिए कि आपने अपने आप को कहा, एक किसी ने बहुत बढ़िया बात की, ये तो आप एक्सप्रेशन सुने होंगे कि पीपल लिविंग ऑन द एज. Somebody says, those who are not living on the edge, they are wasting space. क्या कमाल एक्सप्रेशन. अब देखिए देखने का तरीका है. तो बात सिर्फ ये है कि इंसान थोड़ा आराम थोड़ी मस्ती थोड़ी लेजीनेस में. मैं बच्चों को कह रहा था मैं आप सबको उखाड़ने आया हूँ जहाँ पे आप सेटल हो चुके हैं, क्योंकि जिंदगी में सेटल होना कोई बात ही नहीं है. पहले जमाना था सरकारी जॉब्स में, सब सोचते थे ये सरकारी जॉब है, सेफ है, सिक्योर है, आप चले जाइए. सभी सरकारी जॉब्स में आज कोई भी माफ कीजिएगा लेकिन कुछ ऐसे भी इंडिविजुअल हैं जो बड़े ही कर्मयोगी और ईमानदार हैं. मे बी दे विल मेक अ डिफरेंस इन द गवर्नमेंट आल्सो.
ही डज, ही हैज डन,
ऑब्वियसली. तो कहने का मतलब यह है कि आज इतनी अपॉर्चुनिटीज है, इतनी पॉसिबिलिटीज है. द स्लॉट्स हैव टू बी फिल्ड, द मनी हैज टू बी मेड एंड द टाइम इज नॉट टू बी वेस्टेड. पर कोई ये नहीं कहता वेट अ मिनट, I am not being dragged into that rat race and make that kind of money and be there. Some people say, you know, we want to be rich and famous and they start working towards it. They achieve certain level of richness and being known. But jab aap tapasya pe utarte hain, to paisa aur fame, they follow you, they chase you. Ye insaan ki shaan hai. और इसमें जादू है. तो ये जो एक कॉन्सेप्ट जो मुझे हमेशा चुभता है कि अक्सर हमारे यंगस्टर ये सोच के बैठ जाते हैं, अरे यार वो तो ऐसे घराने का था और वो तो ऐसे पैदा हुआ था, पैदा तू भी हुआ है, वैसे तेरी जरूरत नहीं थी इस दुनिया में. अगर तू इतना ही निमाना हो गया है तो तेरे फिर रहन देना. तो साढ़े कहते कानू रहन दे, कहते मैं देखांगा. You know, that's it. This is all about that energy and challenge. That you say, wait a minute, how can that be? और कमाल की बात यह है कि देखिए, मैं तो ये कहता हूँ कि at this age, I am on a threshold of maybe achieving something different. Because now I can see and understand more and relate to it in a much bigger way. And maybe something good will happen for me. और अगर ये जर्नी की ये एनर्जी नहीं है तो फिर तो सब दुनिया जो है सेटल होके खत्म हो जानी चाहिए, फिर बाकी तो जीने का आनंद ही नहीं बचा. और देखिए ये माँ कैसी थी, क्या बोली थी, कैसे बोली थी. वो माँ कैसी थी, आई टेल यू, शी विल रिंग अप सद्दाम हुसैन, ही विल कम ऑन द लाइन. इफ शी विल रिंग अप क्लिंटन, ही विल कम ऑन द लाइन. If she'll ring up any one of us, we'll say, yes, mother, here we come. So, the basic value system hai, aur usko capture karna, usme energies ka aur expression ka feel lana, nobody can deny that. And nobody can stop you from doing it. And you'll be the genius of your time if you decide it to be so. Thank you so much.
Signed, we have only 100 signed prints by the master, which are available for sale, and he is not taking any royalty from the academy. He is doing this service to the academy. Thank you, Raghu. And these pictures are also available free. रंग केवल रंग नहीं होते, उनके पीछे बहुत सारे लोग होते हैं, रंग बिरंगे कपड़ों वाले लोग। हम सब वो लोग हैं, वो रंग बिरंगे कपड़ों वाले लोग हैं जो भावनाओं के साथ, फीलिंग्स के साथ, इमोशंस के साथ और अपनी अपनी दुआओं के साथ इस एकेडमी को आशीर्वाद दे रहे हैं। मैं आप सब लोगों का बहुत ही तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ और उम्मीद करता हूँ कि फ्यूचर में आप इसी तरह की सपोर्ट हमें देते रहेंगे और रघु जी भी बार बार आते रहेंगे। इन्होंने जब मैं चेयरमैन अत्रे साहब ने अनाउंस किया मुझे, वी वर टुगेदर इन नागालैंड, इसे दीवान अब तेरा क्या बनेगा तेरा, मुझे बोलते
मैं एक बात और भी बता दूँ, ये कह रहे हैं फिर आते रहेंगे। मैं अपनी छोटी बेटी बहुत इंस्टिंक्टिव और बहुत ही हवाओं में मस्ती में जीती है, तो कई दफ़े मैं फ़ोन करता हूँ, दिल्ली से बाहर होता हूँ तो वो लाइन पे आती कहती, पापा आई गॉट नथिंग टू से, बाय बाय, एंड इफ यू इनवाइट मी अगेन आई गॉट नथिंग मोर टू से।